A huge division rivalry game on tap for us in this one. And here's a guy expected to carry a lot of the load for his team on the ground against one of their biggest enemies. It's the Browns going up against the Steelers.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the steel capital of the world, Pittsburgh, PA, and Heinz Field. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with the Cleveland Browns. Fourth down, here comes the Steeler punter Jordan Berry to kick it away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. So here come the Browns for their first drive on offense. Leading the troops out there on the field is Cody Kessler, the second-year quarterback out of USC.
And it felt like in watching the game tape, he got everyone involved last week.
He was a manager.
He really was. That's a great way to put it, because they ran the ball some. They threw it accurately. One touchdown pass, so he didn't, you know, break the bank doing that, but he didn't throw any interceptions. That's the bottom line. That's why a defense loves a quarterback like that. Doesn't put them in bad situations.
And an alley to run. And now running right through it. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Just what the Browns needed there. Good for a gain of 17. First down and 10 now for the offensive group.
Let's go. 3-19.
They go play action here on first down. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. And a peek now at the offense for Cleveland.
Corey Coleman is indeed explosive. The first receiver drafted in 2016, I was drawn to his ball skills while he was at Baylor, meaning anything that's downfield, he's the guy that usually figures out how to get up and get it before the defensive back can react. And then when he gets back down on the ground with the football, look out. His run after catch, usually very impressive.
And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Kessler now to throw, and he's unable to haul it in. So it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field, and that brings up fourth.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secures it.
Here's Jordan Berry now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first.
Hey,
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. Taken from just outside the 30. Call that one an even 60 yards, 6-0. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns offense heading out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. And for them, it's no longer a question of will they make the playoffs. They've clinched the division title. The question, can they hold on to that number one seed?
And this is where the mental fortitude comes to play, doesn't it? Because now you're not just the coach talking about it. It's team talking about it to each other, supporting each other, carrying each other along, because having that number one seed means everything in the NFL.
It does. So even though the division title's clinched, shouldn't take the foot off the gas.
No, not at all. Play it all the way through. I think we've seen that in recent years in the NFL. The teams that play and play to win each and every game, they're the ones to deal with in the playoffs.
The numbers for him from a week ago. Charles, how do you think he ran the football?
I thought he definitely had his moments. I did think that they could have utilized him a little bit better, and I'm definitely going to keep an eye on him to see how they're going to use him this week.
Now a handoff here to his running back. Now he'll be shoved to the turf that time, right at the line of scrimmage. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
Try to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off, William Gay. And the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. The partner just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season. The NFL scoreboard, an update from Foxborough. The Jets are out to the early lead. Still a lot of football left in that affair, but we will for sure keep an eye on it. Boswell on now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. The Browns offense heading out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. And I tell you, we're unbiased, supposed to be here, but it makes me smile when I see the Browns 1-15 a season ago. What a story. Would be a playoff-bound team in 2017. Who would have thought it?
Yeah, smile all you want. I'm actually jumping up and down because, to me, this is one of the great stories of the NFL. They decided to go in a different direction in how they were doing scouting, coaching, all the things that went along with how they evaluated players, and how about the payoff for them in the playoffs for the first time in a long time.
Yeah, first time since 2002. Second down following the run. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
And again, this time to the tailback. And a big hit there as he runs into a brick wall. Looks to be right around the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
And now they'll throw it with Kessler over the middle, and it It's incomplete. Josh Gordon, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
We always talk about receivers. If the ball hits your hand, you're supposed to haul it in. But it is hard to adjust to a pass thrown a little bit behind you.
That one was. All the momentum going forward. Couldn't contort his body back to grab it. Kessler, he finds Coleman, and he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. So one quarter in the books on a cold December afternoon. 7-0 is our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this. Back with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The Browns with a football to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Here to his running back. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Another fine carry from the NFL's rushing leader, and quarterbacks typically dominating the MVP balloting, but I think you got to give this guy serious consideration, don't you?
I agree totally. I mean, he's leading the league in rushing, and let's face it, partner, the running back renaissance in the NFL, it's real, and it's really helping teams along the way. He's a prime example. Got to give him strong consideration for MVP talk.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to bring up a third down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They want it at every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
And not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. To throw is Kessler. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gordon. And that little deke, the juke move that we saw, able to give him the first down yardage before he's brought down. 14 yards, and it's a Cleveland first down. Running back down to the 30 after a gain of three.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
Kessler on second down toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence, haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
The Browns on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7.
Green, 39.
Now Kessler. Here as he's taken down. Stephon Tuitt, he's the one to get him, and that's... Second quarter in Baltimore. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Andy Dalton leading the way offensively. Now he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Getting set to go here, Isaiah Crowell in the offense, trot back out there. And a lot of times you talk about establishing the ground game, probably something they need to do more of here losing in the second quarter.
When you're riding your best horse, you've got to lather him up. The best running backs I've ever talked to, they've all said the exact same thing to me. I'll even break a good sweat until I get to 20 carries.
You're full of good wisdom. Let's see if they can get him into the game more now. Give this time to the tailback. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. A good pickup there for the Browns, 15 yards.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to run by.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know can work and finally getting it done.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Here we go now.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back to Heinz Field after this. A reminder that coming up in 2 minutes, we'll check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando with highlights and analysis of this first half of play.
And I'm going to check in with a heater.
I'm going to be right there with you, partner. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. First down throw for Kessler. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Time a factor as Kessler will get him to the line quickly.
Set, green, 39.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And a big hit at the end of that one. He's knocked down hard. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
The throw to the left side caught by Coleman. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. A great play there. His 25th touchdown. Tying Emmitt Smith for the 5th most in one season. And the Browns are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench.
Here's Jordan Berry now. He's been terrific so far.
Let's go, let's go.
44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Taking it about the 16. Dances by him. Well, nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. A busy final day for you coming up in the NFL. Final day of the year as well. 11 other games going on as we speak. And then coming up later this afternoon, two games each from the AFC West and NFC West all kicking off at the same time. Raiders, Chargers, Chiefs, Broncos, Cardinals, Seahawks, Niners, Rams.
Loving it.
And
loving
then, that's it for the 2017 regular season. It'll be Happy New Year time. Charles, you going to dust off Auld Lang Syne for us tonight?
Meet me at midnight, baby. You'll find out.
Hard pass.
Hurry up, here we go. Green 39.
They go play action with Kessler. And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line. And before the second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one.
Here we go now.
Kessler looks to throw on second down. And he's going to be out of bounds, down to the 25. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe-tap.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the 5. Room here to run. And they'll have excellent field position to begin this drive as he's all the way up to midfield at the 50. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. 13 yards to pick up there. Good for a Cleveland first.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Fresh set of downs here.
Double tight, double tight. Let's go. Back to the end, everybody. Here we go.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
To the tight end, and he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a 2nd and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, no, Jack, Patrick.
Here Then he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. And they got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a third and 2 more.
That's all about doing the dirty work right there defensively. Second and short yardage, that's all about plugging those gaps, not giving the running back a crease to run through. And that's a nice job to hold him just a couple and force a third down.
The Browns on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be 4th down and a few inches.
I'll bet they thought they had picked out with him.
Down at Baltimore, and the Ravens have opened it up a bit, leading by a couple of scores. Joe Flacco, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. This is fielded at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's up over 100 yards, and he'll be looking to get in the end zone again.
Has a tremendous nose for it, doesn't he? The ability to pile up yardage and find the end zone, that's the combination you want in your runner.
That's a combination any coach wants, and we'll see if he can find that end zone once more. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
On 3rd and 2, Kessler looks to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Ryan Shazier. He's the one that gets him down. Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on for the 5th time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And he fields it cleanly. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Browns offense heading out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the AFC. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. And it's all come down to this, hasn't it? Final week of the regular season. As this year's playoffs play out anything like the regular season has gone, could be in for a wild and fun month of January.
And we can break the rules because we can look ahead. All right, there's not a coach out there that's ever said to their team, all right, let's look three weeks down the road. It's always right here, right now. Forget that. Think about what the playoffs are going to look like. The teams that we see that are already in, the teams that are trying to get in, we could have some great matchups.
Now Kessler throwing on 2nd down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. The intended target was Corey Coleman, and it's 3rd down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And now it's Kessler. Over the middle, complete. That's Gordon. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. So the offense has it first and 10. Give it here to his running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. On 2nd down, here's Kessler. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another 1st down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Here we go now.
Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be brought down at about the 25 after a pickup of 4. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on 2nd down.
6 yards to go here on 2nd down.
Here we go.
To throw, Kessler. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Gordon, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on 1st down.
And when you get good yardage like that on 1st down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a 3rd down.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football, but these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
This is 3rd and 2, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Now it's Kessler. This will be caught at about the 5. And he's able to pick up the 1st before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. And they got 3 yards. That's enough. A conversion, and now it's 1st and goal. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. A great effort there. His 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the 4th most in a single season. And the Browns have moved out in front.
Hey, that score deserves our respect, deserves our excitement. But I'm looking at the clock, and I'm thinking, there's a long way to go in this one.
Ideally, they would have liked to milk a little bit.
fourth quarter right now in Atlanta, and the Falcons have wound up winning that football game. Matt Ryan, he was the story there with four touchdown passes. This one taken from the seven. And we've got free football, four quarters done, and we're dead even. We'll have overtime after this timeout. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession.
His way forward here for a good little gain. A nice pickup of six there to get him closer to the end zone, and it'll be second and goal.
Brandon, I go ahead and kick it right now. I know it's only second down, but I kick it and give myself a little margin for error here.
Don't wait for third. Have the extra down just in case.
If something goes wrong, messed up snap, anything like that, you fall on it, guess what? It's third down. You still have the ball. You still have a chance to kick it.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. And I don't think he got in. The big bodies up front held him at the one. Officially no gain on the sneak. Kind of a wasted play there. And now it's third down. Well, they held him out on second down. And now here's third and goal. And he'll give it here to his running back. No gain on the play. And what to do now on fourth and goal?
This drive started with first and goal. Now that it's fourth and goal, anything less than a touchdown.
The final win here means they'll finish at 14-2. And now they'll have the week off as they get set to go after a Super Bowl title. Meanwhile, for Pittsburgh, they wanted desperately to finish at 500, but that won't happen as it'll be a 7-9 season in the end. And they can take solace in the fact that this team never quit all the way to the end. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we sign off from Heinz Field.